Hello everyone, myself Professor P.G.Chitte, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the first session, today we will discuss two-dimensional geometrical transformations. What are the learning outcomes? So the student will be able to explain the different types of geometrical transformations like translation, scaling, and the rotation. Also, they can solve the problems or the numericals based on the 2D geometrical transformations. These are the contents. First, we will discuss what is meant by 2D geometrical transformations, why it is needed. After that, we will see what are the different types of 2D geometrical transformations, that is the translation, rotation, and scaling. Also, the equation of the translation, rotation, and scaling. So what is meant by geometrical transformation? Geometrical transformation is required. So whenever we are doing the modeling, or suppose maybe the drafting, and suppose maybe the one of the part is not observing properly to the user, so we have to do some process. We have to provide some operation, like we have to move the model, we have to move the geometrical entity, or maybe we have to rotate the geometrical entity. For example, maybe the triangle, or maybe the rectangle, or maybe the circle, any geometrical entity. Or maybe we have to zoom in or the zoom out so that we can observe the geometrical entity very properly. So it is defined as the operation that modifies the size, shape, position, and the orientation with respect to its current configuration. Now, what is the in general equation for the 2D geometrical transformation? So P dash is equal to L of P, where P dash is the modified image after the transformation. The transformation may be the translation, scaling, and the rotation. And the P is the original image. What are the different types of 2D geometrical transformation? The first one is, we will see the translation, rotation, and scaling. Now, think about this question. Relate about types of transformation to change in the behavior of the original image. For example, translation. What is meant by translation in general is to change in the position of the original image so that there will be the modified image after the moving of the object, so that we can observe the particular image or the geometrical entity very easily. Think regarding this question. Now, translation. First, we will see the translation. We'll go through the figure. Here, PXY is the original point. P dash, X dash, Y dash is the modified point after the translation. Also, we will take the example of the triangle, where ABC, triangle ABC is our original triangle. And after that, whenever we are providing the translation transformation, we will get the A dash, B dash, C dash, triangle A dash, B dash, C dash. So what is meant by translation? Sometimes, whenever we are performing the geometrical modeling, we have to move a particular object or maybe the model from one coordinate to the another coordinate so that we can see very easily the particular modified object. There will not be any change in the dimension because we are only moving the or translating the object or the geometrical entity. So we can say that it consists of moving an object from one coordinate to the another coordinate without changing its dimension, which is very important, without changing its dimension. The in general equation for the translation, P dash is equal to P plus T, where T is the translation matrix. We'll go ahead. Suppose we are having the xy coordinates. So x dash y dash is equal to xy plus tx ty. Tx ty is translation matrix. So here px dash y dash is equal to pxy plus tx ty. So px dash y dash are the modified coordinates, pxy are the original coordinates, and tx ty is our translation matrix. Similarly for the triangle ABC. So a dash x, a dash y, b dash x, b dash y, and c dash x, c dash y is equal to, this will be our modified triangle, that is a triangle a dash, b dash, c dash is equal to a x, a y, b x, b y, c x, c y. This will be our original triangle, that is triangle ABC plus tx, ty, triangle, sorry, the matrix tx, ty. This will be our translation matrix. Now, we'll move forward to the rotational transformation, rotational geometrical transformation. We'll go through the figure first. Here, pxy is our original coordinate. Now, we have to rotate this pxy through the angle theta, which is having the radius r, so that we can get the new coordinate, which is called as p dash x dash y dash. So, p is our original coordinate and p dash is our modified coordinate. So, why to rotate actually maybe a geometrical entity or maybe the point? So that similarly like the translation, so that we can see a geometrical entity very easily. In the sum of the geometrical model, 3D geometrical model, we can't see a particular surfaces. We have to rotate that particular surface so that we can observe very easily that particular surface. Now, it consists of taking an object from one coordinate to the another coordinate at particular angle, where theta is the rotational angle. Now, we'll go through a derivation here. We have to find out the rotational matrix here. So, x is equal to r cos phi and y is equal to r sin phi. So, x dash is equal to r cos theta plus phi. We are knowing that cos theta plus phi is equal to r cos theta cos phi minus r sin theta sin phi. So, from the equation 1, x dash is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta, because we are keeping the values of the x and y. X is equal to r cos phi and y is equal to r sin phi. So, we can get x dash is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta. Similarly, y dash is equal to r into sin theta plus phi. R into sin theta plus phi. So, sin theta plus phi. R into sin theta cos phi plus r cos theta sin phi, keeping the values of x and y here. So y dash is equal to x sin theta plus y cos theta. Combining together 2 and 3, we will get the particular matrix. So x dash y dash is equal to xy. So x dash y dash will be our original coordinates. Sorry, the modified coordinates. Xy will be our original coordinates. And cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, right? So cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta, that will be our rotational matrix. So cos theta sin theta, that is minus sin theta cos theta, that will be our rotational matrix. Scaling. Now, here we are having sx and sy, the scaling coordinates, or we can call the scaling distances from the 0, 0 point. Triangle ABC is our original triangle. Triangle A dash, B dash, C dash, our modified triangle. Now, why scaling is required? So, scaling is required whenever you want to zoom in or zoom out the particular geometrical model. So, whenever you are dealing with the complex problems like the engine or maybe the chassis, we have to zoom in or zoom out so that we can go into the particular surface or maybe the solid edge or maybe a node very easily. We have to zoom in and zoom out. There are the different modeling softwares like CATIA or maybe the SolidWorks, with the help of which we can zoom in and zoom out. But manually, if you want to take the scaling in the drawing sheet, we can zoom in and zoom out. But with the help of CATIA software, which is very easily we can done. So scaling is a type of transformation to zoom in and zoom out of the object or the drawing. So original coordinates are multiplied uniformly by the scaling factor SX and SY in the direction X and Y respectively. We will see the equation. So X dash is equal to X into SX and Y dash is equal to Y into SY. Very simple equation. So A dash X A dash Y is equal to AX AY into SX 0 and 0 SY for the triangle ABC. So this will be our modified triangle, that is triangle A dash B dash C dash. So A dash X A dash Y B dash X B dash Y C dash X C dash Y is equal to triangle ABC, that is AX AY BX BY CX CY into SX 0 0 SY. And this will be our scaling matrix. Always remember, in the translation matrix there will be the addition. In the scaling and the rotational matrix there will be the multiplication. These are the references. Thank you.